I greet you again in the joy of our Lord, and I thank you, Elder Gilbert, as always, for leading us in the reading of God's written word. And right now, there is a timely proclaimed word for us, and I'd like to address you from the topic, blessed to be broken. Now, my tablet is acting very silly, so I have to read my sermon text from my phone, and I'm in denial about how old my eyes are, so if you see me going like this, just excuse me in advance, amen. So when you think of the word blessed, what normally comes to mind? Is it being in a place in your life where everything is going smoothly? Does it mean that things around you are perfectly in place, or at least they're on their way to being in place? Does it mean that you and your family and your friends and everyone around you, they're happy, they're healthy, they're prospering? Is that what blessed means? Does it mean that your career is going well, your business is taking off? Does it mean that your friendships are all in good places? Does it mean that your love life is on point, that your marriage is thriving, that your schooling is going well? Is that what being blessed means? I think if any of these things are in place, we would consider ourselves blessed, amen? If we were to tweet or to Facebook about any of these things going on, we would probably include the hashtag blessed. In fact, I've seen some of you do it. And it's always wonderful. I'm glad to see that you are blessed and that everything is going well and that you are blessed. But is being blessed an end to which we should strive? Is it a goal, a final destination? Do we work and pray and work some more to arrive at the land of blessed? Or is being blessed just the beginning? Is it a precursor to something else? Rather than being a destination, is it instead a starting point? What if something happens after being blessed? I would submit that being blessed is not in fact a destination. It's only a part of the story. It's just a beginning of any story that makes up the anthology of our faith journey. Whenever you sit back and you take inventory of your life and you conclude that you are blessed, that's wonderful. However, be prepared because something will come after that. I notice in the Gospels that Jesus has a habit of blessing things and then breaking them. In our text this morning, there's a prime example of that. Jesus thought he was going on a little vacation. He was gonna go on a retreat. But it turns out that a lot of people really felt like they needed Jesus, and so they followed him. But instead of saying, you know, I'm on vacation right now, I'm on a retreat, I'm taking a break, he had pity on them. He pitied them and he healed their sick. But as the day went on, it was getting late. And the disciples, being the pragmatists that they were, encouraged Jesus to tell them to go on so they can buy themselves some food. So they can go to McDonald's or something, to get something to eat. Jesus had another plan. They would feed the crowds, but the two measly little fish and five measly little loaves of bread that they had. And he began this dinner party by taking the loaves and blessing them. And then he breaks them. Unless these were gigantic loaves of bread, theologically, I must deduce that the only way five loaves of bread could feed 5,000 men, not including the women and children, is because they were blessed. They were first lifted up to heaven, and they were blessed. But even though they were blessed, they're still useless. In order for these loaves to be useful, the loaves had to be broken. They had to be broken so that they could be distributed to all of the hungry people. They had to be broken so that the blessing that they carried could be shared. It's good that we folks of faith know that the only way we can do the things that we do and enjoy the things that we enjoy is due to God's blessing. It's good that we know that. It's important to understand that if we enjoy any measure of health or financial security or career success or any other such enjoyments, it's because we've been blessed to do so. Amen. But being blessed by itself is useless. It's useless. We must then be broken. A story comes to mind of when I was in fifth grade. And there was a teacher who was going on some errands, and my teacher, Mrs. Strong, I remember her name, she asked this teacher who was running errands, "Hey, can you bring me back a Kit Kat?" So she said, yeah. So the other teacher leaves to go on the errands, and sure enough, she brings back a Kit Kat bar for my teacher, Mrs. Strong. Now, all of us kids, we get the idea to sing the Kit Kat jingle. For no reason, we just thought it would be funny. We just thought it would be the most clever thing in the world. We didn't want the candy. We just wanted to be silly and make her laugh. So when she comes back in the room with her Kit Kat bar, we all time it and we break out in the song. Give me a break, give me a break. Break me off a piece of that Kit Kat bar. See, y'all know it. So, and it goes off without a hitch. She laughs, mission accomplished. So we think we're just the funniest things and we're so clever, and then something happens. She gets up. She proceeds to give each and every one of us a small piece of her Kit Kat bar. And then she goes back to her desk and eats the remaining piece, this little remaining piece, just as contently as if she had the whole thing to herself. And we were stunned. We didn't expect that. And she's just eating the rest of it, but she's happy about it. She was. I remember being amazed by that, because as a 10-year-old chocoholic, there is no way I would ever share my chocolate with anybody and be happy about it. Listen, even at 35, I might not share my chocolate with you. I have to be feeling pretty generous to share my chocolate with you. But she did. And she didn't miss out on anything. She had plenty left over. I think we're often reluctant to be broken because we're afraid of what will be missing in case we are. We're afraid of what will be missing when that happens. When we're broken in our relationships, we're afraid of missing out on the good times that we used to have with that person. When we're broken financially, we're afraid of losing everything that we worked so hard for, what God had blessed us with. When churches are broken, and they're often broken, we're afraid that it will mean the decline of our faith tradition. But the fact is that God is especially good at using broken things. It's in that brokenness that God can spread you out among those who need you. Perhaps losing a job now means that you can be more present with your family, or volunteer at the soup kitchen. Perhaps a fractured relationship means that new ones can come in and be fostered. Perhaps a major disappointment means that you can comfort someone else in the midst of their disappointment because you're now acquainted with that hurt and you know how much they need someone. Being broken is actually a sign that you've been blessed. And now the blessing has to reach out to beyond just you. That was Jesus' pattern. To bless things, only to break them and redistribute them. That was the path of his own life, to be broken on the cross and to then get up on Sunday morning with all power in his hand. And with that in mind, I thank God for brokenness. I thank God that he was crushed with pain. I thank God that Jesus was wounded for our transgressions. I thank God that his punishment made us whole, because without his wounds, we couldn't be healed. I thank God for brokenness. Brothers and sisters, wherever the brokenness may occur, don't fear it. Don't be afraid of it. Yes, it's uncomfortable. Yes, it's disappointing. It presents some uncertainties, but trust in God's willingness and ability to work it out. Trust that there will be beauty for ashes. Trust that where there is weeping one night, joy is going to replace it the next morning. Trust that God will never leave nor forsake you. Trust that you are blessed, even and especially when you're broken. And even when you're broken, there's still about 12 baskets left for you. Amen. Dear God, help us to not fear the brokenness. Help us to trust you, whether things are comfortable or uncomfortable, whether they're enjoyable or challenging. Remind us, Lord, of why we're blessed in the first place, and remind us that our brokenness is not a condemnation. No, you just need to use us elsewhere. You need to use us differently. Lord, we're still whole because we're still in you. Help us to trust your work. Break us, Lord, so that we can go wherever you need us to go, and we can do whatever you need us to do. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. Let us reaffirm our trust in God today as we sing.